So why was it that I was happy to be among them? I took their company in whatever form it came, just as a starving person eats whatever she finds. I was put at the back of the class so I wouldn't obscure the view of the other children, and I found myself grinning at the funny way the teacher's arm jiggled when she wrote with chalk on the board, at the bee doing a loop-de-loop outside the window, threatening to fly in. I gripped my pencil, but against my will, it snuck up to my face and made a curly mustache on my upper lip. Curls and more curls, the delicious lead wood smell, and the sharp tip of the pencil tickling my skin. Waiting for the others to turn to me was almost more than I could bear, and my eyes grazed fondly from one child to the next. The funny boy with the ring of dirt around his neck, the cross-eyed girl with braids and corrective glasses. Grace was her name. Grace seemed almost like a friend, though we'd never spoken directly. I tried to predict what she might think was funny and curled my top lip to hold my pencil there. I crossed my eyes for her and plugged my ears with erasers. At recess, my heart thumped with the thought of going close to her, but she could see me coming, even when I approached from behind. Maybe her glasses gave her special spin-around vision. It was as though we held an invisible, unbendable pull between us, for whenever I moved close, she moved just that distance away. Little shoulders, little ears, little ski jump nose. I put my hand out from yards away and pretended to stroke her hair. I stood alone in the playground as the swings flew and the monkey bars filled up with children. My hands reached almost to my knees. I was all wrong, out of proportion. I listened to the hiss of the pulp and paper mill across the river, to the whir of the factory where Elspeth had worked. The wind hugged me. It made whispering sounds, circled my feet with a trailing of sand, then spiraled around me, up, up, until I was reeling. If I closed my eyes, the children's voices faded, and all I could hear was the whistling of the atmosphere, someone far off calling me. It was a spooky sound, but reassuring too. Somewhere, someone knew me and was waiting for me to come.